the best way to eat your snacks and still look like a snack. This video today is, as titled, is what I call the best quarantine diet. If you're like anybody else during this quarantine, I'm sure you got a lot of snacks, you probably in the grocery store. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you got a lot of snacks in your house. And when you're bored, you probably eat. When you're stressed, you probably eat. When you're happy, you probably eat. And all that extra stuff, being bored and stressed out, does not help. So I'm eating all the time because I eat for all the moods. But this is my opinion. The best quarantine diet, the best diet to help you maintain your weight, the best way to eat your snacks and still look like a snack. And that would be intermittent fasting. Now, I hope you don't turn it off and get scared and, oh, fasting, and you hear fasting, you want to tune out. No, just listen to me. There's so many more benefits than just fat loss to this diet. It's been proven to help with your body, to help with your metabolism, to help with your skin, your organs. It's just been proven to basically help you overall health-wise, because like I said in my other videos, like, you need a break when you work, you need a break when you work out. Like, your body needs a break when it's digesting all the crap that you're consuming. If you're consuming food throughout the day and throughout the night, your body doesn't get a break. It's always working and breaking down and digesting that food. So when you give your body a break, it has more time to focus on all the other crap and push it out. Now, how does intermittent fasting work? It's like, intermittent fasting is basically, it's not necessarily like a diet, because like I said, you can almost eat. You'll see millions of videos saying eat whatever you want and still lose weight. Eat cheeseburgers and Taco Bell, still lose weight. Some people, yes, have done that, but is it really healthy? So I don't encourage you to do this just so you can eat crap. I encourage you to do this just to make you not feel like crap when you're eating crap, because it's okay to have those foods here and there, as long as you're not overindulging in it. And if you are somebody who's overindulging in it, this is one way to still kind of help your body out, push that crap out. And the way intermittent fasting works is you have a feeding window, and it's usually from 8 hours to 10 hours. Some people jump to 12, but you really want to leave it down to that 8 hours. If you're new to this, you could do a 10 hour or a 12 hour, but I do definitely recommend that 8 hour feeding window. So you have 8 hours throughout the day that you eat, and then 16 hours that you're fasting. And you're probably thinking, oh God, 16 hours without food. Food, honey, chill, come back. All right. It's not that bad, because half of that time, at least 8 hours, I'm saying at least because if you're quarantined, I know y'all sleeping a lot, but at least 8 hours of that, you're sleeping. So it's really not that bad. Like, usually mine, when I started, I was doing like a 10 to 6, and then I went to 11-7. Now I'm officially at a 12 to 8, because I don't know what's going on with this quarantine time, but my body, my mind does not want to go to sleep at night. I used to be somebody that's in bed by like 8:30, 9 o'clock, and up by like 4:35 a.m. But the way this quarantine set up, I'm up late, so I had to change my feeding window from 10 to 6 to 12 to 8. So if I am up till like 11 or 12 o'clock at night, I'm not crazy hungry and I still can go to sleep. So you gotta organize the time that's most convenient for you. If you're somebody that's up to 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, make your feeding time later. You could do, like, I'm doing a 12 to 8, you could do a 2 to 10. Like, it really doesn't matter, as long as your body gets that break. And yes, your sleep is important. Try to get, it's 68 hours, I always say 7. They say 68 hours, I say aim for 7. But of course you want to get your 8 hours, 9, 10. Go crazy. You're quarantined, you have time. If you're not a mom like me, I'm pretty sure you have plenty of time to sleep more. The reason why I'm making this video after I just released my 21-day challenge that starts tomorrow is because your eating is just as important as your workout. Now, if you saw my video yesterday and you're willing and you're about to jump in the challenge tomorrow, I definitely recommend you add this diet with it. If you do this diet with it and you do your workouts first thing in the morning, I have another video on my page about fasted cardio. I'll link it in the description box. But if you do my workout, that this 21-day challenge, first thing in the morning on an empty stomach, you're gonna see major results. And now if you're gonna add this intermittent fasting diet to it as well and do it all together, just aim to get your workout done an hour before your feeding window. Like mine's at 12, so I would work out at 11. Gives me time to get my workout in, calm down, take a shower, and then go eat and enjoy my day. And I don't know about you, but I feel amazing when I have my workouts in the morning. So again, back to intermittent and fasting. For me, I eat from 12 to 8. Now, that first meal of the day is the most important meal of the day, breakfast. Your first morning's most important meal of the day, breakfast. Yeah, meal. My first meal is usually my biggest meal. You definitely wanna make sure it's full of protein, full of veggies, and you can get your carbs and healthy fat in that. Now, me, personally, I think I've talked about this on my channel before. I like to follow a low-carb diet just because I don't care too much for carbs, not because, oh, it burns fat faster. I mean, carbs burn fat. No carb diet burns fat. Carb diet burns fat. It depends on you and your body. You need to find out what works out for you. But most definitely, with the workouts, make sure you have your protein for sure and your healthy fats in that first meal. And you want it to be healthy. And I'm not too worried about a lot of you doing this. You're probably thinking, oh, I'm gonna be so hungry, I'm just gonna eat donuts and when you're doing intermittent fasting, like, you kind of want that first meal to be really healthy. So, I mean, the first thing you put in your body, kind of want it to be healthy. I don't know if that's just me, but I've heard other people say that. So, like I said, again, protein, veggies, carbs, and healthy fats. Aim for that. And like I said, my first meal of the day is my biggest meal of the day. Now, a lot of people, I've heard a lot of people done this, and they had like two freaking meals or something like that. Under eating is just as bad as overeating. Just because we're fasting or we only have a feeding window of 8 hours does not mean we're eating less. We're just eating in a less amount of time. So if you're somebody that eats 4 to 6 meals a day, get those 4 to 6 meals a day in that feeding window. You get to eat a lot. And do you want pizza, baby? Eat your pizza. Eat your cookies. I'm not saying go crazy, but do not torture yourself. And that's another thing about fitness and dieting and fitness. It, like, this is a lifestyle. If you're freaking miserable with what you're eating and what you're doing, then you're not gonna continue and you're not gonna be happy doing it. And you're kind of just, it's counterproductive because you're doing it, but you're stressed the hell out. And that stress is kind of just knocking out everything you're doing because it's blocking your body from doing the work it needs to do to get rid of all the fat that you're burning during your workouts. I do this diet because, hey, I like my snacks. I love my pizza, my wings, my burritos, my nachos. I love eating all that. And I don't really want to deprive myself completely of that stuff. So that's why I went back, because I've done this before. I went back to intermittent fasting. Like I said, nutrition is important and your exercising is important. Now, if you're somebody out there that's watching just this video and you don't care anything about the 21-day challenge, I definitely recommend this diet for anybody, because yes, even if you're not active, you still can see results with this lifestyle. I'm not gonna say diet, I'm gonna say lifestyle, because it's a lifestyle. Now, like I said, I'm not encouraging you to do this diet to completely eat crap. I say go by the 70-30-80-20 rule. Basically, 80% of everything you're eating or 70% of everything you're eating is a healthy diet. You wanna put stuff in your body that has some type of nutritional value. Very rare that I eat anything that doesn't have any type of nutritional value. And honey, pizza still has some nutrition in there, you know, tomatoes and proteins and what. Definitely stick for the 80-20 rule. If you need help with your diet, I will send you a free meal plan guide. It has it laid out, proteins, veggies, carbs, like the different types that you can eat, how much of each one to eat every day. And also drink your water, water, water. Water is important. Make sure you're drinking water throughout this entire thing. And with the intermittent fasting, you're only breaking your fast with food or anything that contains more than 10 calories. So you can drink your water, you can drink your tea. I'm not a coffee drinker, so I don't know how much calories is in it. And I think it's under 10 calories. Depending on how much calories is in your coffee, you maybe it'll have in the morning. But it does have to be plain coffee. You can't put stuff in it. You can't put sugar and all that stuff that your body has to digest in it. But like I said, I drink green tea. Teamy Tea, Teamy Detox. I'll leave a link in the description box. You can get 20% off with my code. I either stick with that or my green tea. Actually, I usually mix both of them together every morning. And you can have water as well, and that will not break your fast. So it's okay, just drink lots of water until your feeding window comes. And I think that's about it. If you have any questions or concerns or anything more about intermittent fasting, I may not have covered everything, but definitely leave a comment below and I'll respond to you. Make sure you follow my fitness Instagram. I actually have a video on how to use my meal plan guide on my fitness Instagram. Make sure you're following Flex Queen Fitness on Instagram. My personal is Nicole Jarie. They both link to each other, so it doesn't matter which one you follow, you'll find the other. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye.